taken the boat from Malmö to Barsebäcks hamn to go and pick up our head sails that are getting new UV covers.
So we're on our way to Rå, half an hour to the north, to pick up maybe both our sails, but probably only one, the Sailmaker. I don't think both of them are ready. We have borrowed my parents' car, so yeah, let's go.
Alla med. Hej älskling. Du är med.
Hej du.
Trött. Cameras and stuff.
Yeah, always stuff.
Loft, and Håkan is also here, and Håkan and Malin, very nice name, they are running this together, so they have the mast and rigging and then the sail loft, and they are kind of working together for with clients. So we have our Genoa out here, and Malin will start to put the UV cover, UV protection on it now. So Malin, what have you done so far with our Genoa sail?
I started to put on a UV cover. This is a sailcloth from Contender, specially made for just UV protection. And then I'm going to take it to the machine and see.
And this is like a sticker you put on, and then you sew it also.
Yeah. Yeah.
And why is it important to have a UV protection?
Well, the sun do a lot of damage to the sailcloth. It just take a couple of years, and then the cloth starts to feel like paper. Mm. And you can throw the sail away eventually. So I think it's very important. You should not have a sail that doesn't have UV protection on it.
Can you say, like, does it take much of the life of the sail off if you don't have it?
Yeah, yeah, many years.
Yeah.
And so it's cheaper to put a new UV cover on than to buy a new sail.
Yeah, of course. And you should do this how often? How long do they last?
It depends on how much you use them. Mm.
And where, maybe also in the world, like how much sun they get.
Yeah, of course. But at least once a lifetime. Mm.
What do you think about the shape of our sail, this sail?
Yeah, well, it's used, but it's still in a good shape. I think you can use it some years. It doesn't behave the same way as a Decrum. Mm. It keeps the shape much more.
Okay. Yeah, because this is a special cloth, right, that the sailmaker had, cruising laminate,
yes,
it was called, yeah.
Yes.
And it's 12 years old,
yeah,
but you say it still has some years.
Yes, it always depends on how much you use it, how much it's exposed for the sun and stuff. So you can't say that a sail lasts like that long, so many years. Mm. Maybe a Dacra, maybe it's 10 to 15 years, but it depends on how much you use it, of course. Yeah.
So when it's time to do the service,
yeah,
what should you keep in mind when, if you have a boat and you look at the sails? Because you said you should bring them to service
every other year.
Yeah. So what should you keep in mind to look out for when it starts going bad or something?
Always look at the leech, the UV protection maybe.
And the leech is this part, or?
Yes.
Yeah, this side of the sail.
In the main sail, you can check at the buttons and see how, so they don't make holes in the sail.
Yeah.
Of course, the clue is always
this part.
So, yes, always look out for the seams and see if anything is about to
going bad or yeah.
What type of stuff should you bring on the boat to make emergency repairs? I mean, if a seam like this gives up and you're out at sea, what's the best way to deal with that? Is it like this silver tape or?
That's kind of the worst thing you can put on a sail.
Yeah.
There are repair kits you can buy.
Yeah.
That are just for sailcloth. If you put other kinds of tape on it,
yeah.
It destroys the cloth around it, mm-hmm. and it makes it harder to keep the right shape in the sail.
And the reason for that it destroys the areas around the tape, is it because of the glue or is it because it doesn't breathe?
It doesn't breathe.
So it destroys the
cloth. So the wind pushes aside and go through the sail on each side of these tapes.
Okay.
So it, yeah, it loses shape.
But we used to have like a roll of Dacron, but with the sticky back side.
Yeah,
that's fine to use that also for a longer, you know, or should you remove that as soon as possible or can you let it stay there?
Or when you can reach a sailmaker who can help you to repair it the right way,
yeah,
you should do that.
Getting a new sail wardrobe is a very big expense, so we're happy that we can extend the life of these sails with a few more years.
Molly, all these machines, they have different names.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Well, different people over the years who have named them.
Huh?
From different reasons, and the woman who used to use that machine, she loved Kevin Costner, so it's called Kevin. and
the one that is called like the roar, vrålet.
Yeah, you will hear the sound.
Okay.
Later.
It will explain itself when it's
yeah.
running.
Yes.
And there are so many machines. Do you use yeah. them all?
Yeah, well, almost everyone, actually. They all fill their purpose.
Okay.
This I usually use for UV protection. And I have this one for spinnakers. And for smaller sails and larger sails.
Yeah, great to have.
Yeah, and boat covers and things.
The price for getting new UV protection is around 45 euros per meter, which is much less than getting a new sail.
So here's our cutter sail. We'll take this with us today. It's finished. The Genoa will be finished in a few days. So the sail back to Malmö will be with the cutter and the mainsail. But it's so great to have newly washed sails and a new UV protection on them.
Thank you so much, Malin, for showing us your sail loft. Hope you enjoyed this episode and this weekend's double special. Thanks for watching and please subscribe and help us reach 100,000 subscribers.